Okay, so I have your profile here. You were born in June 1942 at Koforidua.
It was wrong.
It was wrong?
Yeah.
You were not born in 1942?
No.
So how come you have this? Signed by the head of state and chairman of the Supreme Military Council, General Ignatius Kutuechampa, CSG.
I don't know who gave this story to him. As you rightly said, I have done it all. So when somebody was writing this, anyway, I should have been consulted.
But you are not.
But the reason why the mistake came was, you see, presently, we have been cheating of age groups in football.
So they changed your...
No, in those days, before you are sent to school, because our parents didn't just documented anything about our age, you have to put your hand over your head like what I've just done to touch your ear before you
go to class one.
That is why 1942.
Okay, so what is your actual year of birth?
1940.
Oh, so this is 2 years late.
Late.
Okay. Oh, that's interesting. Anyway, so did you ever protest?
No.
You never did?
Because of the football age.
Okay, but we still have football age.
Yes.
It hasn't gone away.
At all.
Times have changed, but we still have a 42-year-looking man, I don't want to mention him, telling us that he's 26 years old. And so they get on the pitch and they can't even run because their bones are brittle.
It is doing them harm than good.
Okay.
If I remember a player from here, went to Germany, beat the age down, and when he got sick, he was down with malaria. They had to inject him with the children's medicine. So he nearly died. You know, and a friend of mine was also in Belgium. You know, they saw the height and the age. They were doubting, so they put him on a special diet. For 3 consecutive years, he was still as he was when we went there.
Mm-hmm.
So they got to know, the blacks, we are different from the whites, because they drink milk and become so tall and huge. But here, I don't know why. Look at me at the age of 73. I am still as I was when I was a young man.
Oh, you're 73?
Yeah.
Oh, wow. You're blessed.
Yeah.
Yes. So how do we deal with the age cheating phenomenon in football? Because even with technology, now we have the MRI.
Yeah.
But still, we have the problem.
Luckily, yesterday I was with Alhaji Ibrahim Sunday, mm-hmm. and he said FIFA has written something about what you are, the cheating. So they asked for his comments, and he has suggested that at the age of 12, this biometric machine, when you put your finger down at the age of 12, that will carry you to the end of your life, and that will stop the cheating at the age of 12, because you can't cheat after 12.
Okay.
So, and that is going to help them. I think they are going to adopt those things. And the MRI, as you said, there was recently a whole Nigerian team was disqualified,
yes,
because of the MRI. So,
yes,
it is going to stop.
But can you understand the pressures these young men go through and why they need to reduce their age? Because by the time he gets a big team in Europe, he's probably already 22 years old.
This is the problem. And who is to be blamed? You know.
You can't blame the player, can you?
At all. Like when I started, I completed my elementary school living certificate in 1958. And I remember after school, my father was in Tema when the harbor had just started as a driver. So I had to come and stay with him as a mate. And behind our house was a football pitch where Tema gurus in football do come and play there. At my size and my age at that time, you were just saying, when they line up, I'll go and be in the line. But as soon as the two teams are separated, when they are counted and about 14, oh, small boy, sit down. For 3 months, which I thought I could have done better by that time. So only one day, well, we didn't go to Takoradi for the trip that I was there, I knew I'll be asked to go and sit down. I didn't even take my boots. So when I got there, the line was only 12. So it was small. Sit down. If somebody gets injured, you can come in. So, and I prayed.
That somebody will get injured.
So immediately, where is the small boy? I said, I came in. And they put me at the number two. I think if you put me in the goal, I will keep it because I want to play.
Yeah.
And then within 15 minutes, the referee whistled and stopped the play. He said, where are your boots? I said, it's in the house. And he told them, let him go and bring his boots first. After the training, you know, I was seeking for a job because I was a mate to my father's car. Mm-hmm. I had 6 jobs after the training, one day training. The elderly people got to know that there's something in me. So immediately after that, I told my father, I'm no more a mate. I've got a job.
You have a job.
Yeah.
And that was what carried you through. Let's talk about your time with Kumasi Asante Kotoko, because you won the African Championship Cup with Kotoko in 1970.
Yeah.
And at the same time, you were crowned Goal King.
Yeah.
Yes. If you look at Kotoko then and Kotoko now, what has changed?
A lot of things have changed. Okay. Nowadays, people leave Kotoko to trade abroad. In those days, it was Kotoko and Kotoko alone. There were no professionals. We were purely amateurs playing for the love of the game, not even money. I remember there was a match between Kotoko and Haas. Our winning bonus was 2 cedis. We complained bitterly. We told the executive members, if they don't increase to 2 cedis, 50 pesos, Haas will beat us. It took them 2 weeks to come to conclusion that now they are giving the 50 to us. So, I just for the books, I played first for Accra House of Oaks
okay.
in 1961. The whole season, we won the league. At that time, Ohinigan was the director of sports, and there was this Republicans, Osajifor's own club, which was a standby national team for Ghana. He thought they would win the league, so he made some medals, stating that was the only league trophy with a medal attached to it. So I had my medal from Accra House of Oaks, which is in my house now, as a player for Accra House of Oaks, which has won the national league before. Before I left for Kotoko.
How did the fans take your switch? Because that is traditionally the rival of Kumasi Asante Kotoko.
Abba, it's a short story, not a long one. When I came to Tema to live with my father, there was a Krobo woman my father was married to, who didn't like me personally at all because I was not her child. And because of that, I decided to leave my father's house to go and stay with friends because of football. And when I joined House of Oaks, winning the trophy, I was myself and my girlfriend won the trophy for Accra House of Oaks. So I was happy with Accra House of Oaks. I was in the clubhouse one day when my father came there telling me he wanted to divorce the woman. So there is somebody, he was a driver to Mr. B.K. Aduse, who happens to be a patron of Kotoko. So Mr. B.K. has promised that if I go to Kotoko, he will give the £30 for my father to go and pay for the course so that my father will leave the woman. I was so happy that the woman that has been troubling me and is going, £30, then I have to go to Kotoko. In the night, I just pack up. In those days, no transfer, nothing. But I made a mistake, as you have told the House of Oak officials.
How did they take it? They were distraught?
I nearly died.
Ooh.
For 8 members, I couldn't kick a ball spiritually.
What, you think they tweaked something?
Yes. So I was looked after by a woman. I still remember her, Mamia Fiesa, at Abu Abuja in Ashanti region. You see, that is why I'm now a man of God, because of what I saw throughout my football career.
Is the juju real?
Do you believe in witchcraft?
No.
You don't?
No.
And then you are lucky. Are you a Christian?
Yes.
Why did Jesus Christ come?
For our sins.
And to destroy the works of the enemy. Mm-hmm. Who is the enemy? Those things. Mm-hmm. And Satan. You know, in the garden where Adam was created into, when Jesus Christ, Satan wanted to test, he said, Adam has given all the power to me, so if you can bow down, I'll give you everything. And Jesus just told him that we have to serve only God and God alone. You know, so these things are there.
Let's talk about your time briefly. With the Black Stars, you were part of the team, the 1963 group that won the African Cup of Nations.
Yeah.
And, you know, after the last time we won, that's just...
82.
So almost 30 years, or 31 years.
31 years.
There's been a drought in this country. We haven't won any major trophy. Meanwhile, we invest so much in coaches. The investment we've made in foreign coaches can probably build another hospital, you know, alongside Kulebu Teaching Hospital.
That is true.
Yeah, and we haven't had anything. What do you think is wrong with football administration now? And on record, you didn't win that title with a foreign coach, did you?
No.
Okay.
All the four that we have won were by black coaches. And this thing, I was in my house one day when a friend called. He said, do you know what is happening? We won the first trophy in 1963 under Dr. Kwame Nkrumah. We defended it in Tunisia in 1965 under the same president. 68, it was a different story altogether. Kwame Nkrumah has been overthrown.
Yeah.
And in 82, I was even the coach for Asante Kotoko, who used Kotoko as a nucleus for the Blasters to qualify for Libya, which Kwashi was the captain who won the last trophy. Now, we have won four. This is where, spiritually, any fifth match that Ghana gets to the finals or anywhere, they will be beaten. 2008, host and win. We hosted the Africa Cup of Nations in Ghana here.
And bowed out miserably.
At the fifth match, that was against Cameroons. 2010.
We went to the final in Angola.
We went to Angola. We didn't play the first match because of the Togolese problems.
Yeah.
And the last, that is the fifth match, was against the same Egypt. They beat us. And in that match, that was the match we could have won because we played better than the Egyptians. And Asamoah was the one goal project player. He took us to the finals. And the white man who was a coach, Asamoah was tired. We were down by a goal. Then if you want to replace somebody, you took Asamoah off and brought in a defender. Nanaba, the team that they have the 11 players, we have half of them who are destroyers and half who are constructors. That is the four line. The constructors are almost causing heavier than the defenders because to destroy. You see this small goalpost. The defenders are destroying not for you to put the ball inside. And we, the four line player, we are also cracking our brains just to pass them and just put the ball there. Then you bring in a defender. So the last pass that came that Ghana could have even equalized for an extra time, it came onto the defender that came in, Ado. And he destroyed it. So these are some of the things that we always...
So tactically, we need to be focused. This is it.
Okay.
Before I let you go, would you say it is right for the coach of the present team, the Black Stars, to call up Olele?
I personally don't know why Olele was asked to stay out. Because I know footballers, especially the goalkeepers, they last longer than any player on the pitch.
They're like wine. They get better with age.
In 1965, the goalkeeper that we won the cup from, 1965, was the same person who Razak scored a golden goal against in 1978 in Accra. The same goalkeeper. So goalkeepers last longer. Now, if they feel they need him because of experience-wise, and there is nothing wrong with it.
Okay. Thank you very much, Rev.Osei Kofi.
Yeah, man.
Thanks for your time. So